All right, welcome to lesson 3.2 in the Video for Entrepreneurs course. This is the lesson in the third module, which is all about editing your videos. In the previous lesson, we talked about everything to do with recording using Tella, and now we're going to edit our video using Tella. We're gonna split our editing into three main topics. The first one is gonna be fixing mistakes and tidying up our original recordings. The second is going to be adding style and customizing the appearance of our video. And the third is going to be adding zoom effects to highlight important information in our videos. It's important to remember that the things that we're spending time on in this course are all about how to help us as entrepreneurs creating demos, tutorials, and online courses. So we're not trying to make every single video in the world. We're trying to make a really great product demo or tutorial or course. All right, so let's start with fixing our mistakes. At this point, we have recorded our clip, so now we're gonna head into the Tella editor to trim and split those videos and remove any unwanted parts so that we can make our recordings more watchable. So here we are in the Tella editor, and down the bottom left, you can see that we've got all of our clips, clip 1 through to clip 4. Now, the first thing you want to do before going and trimming and splitting your clips is to play back your videos, preview each of your clips, and make sure you know what's in them and what you actually want to remove. So I've already given mine a preview, so now we can jump into the trim mode and start tidying them up. So to do that, head up to the top right here and click trim. That will take you into the trim mode. You will see a preview of your video for each of the clips that you're on. You'll then see a timeline, which has a waveform which indicates where the speech in your video is happening. And these parts where you don't see the waveform, those are silences. And so now what we want to do is remove the parts that we don't want. So the first thing that I would do is probably want to remove the silence at the start. And I also want to remove some of the silence at the end here. And the way to do that in Tella is really easy. You just click on the handle and then you can drag that to the point at which you want it to start. So you can see now that the starting frame is me looking at the camera, mouth closed, before I'm about to say something. So we can just preview this and make sure that that looks good.
Hey, Grant here from Tella.
Perfect. So that's exactly where I would want this to start. There's no pause or delay at the beginning. It goes straight into my speech. So then at the other end, we can see that we've got a long silence here. And in actual fact, this last part here, this is some extra rambling I started doing towards the end of the video. So I don't want that in there either. So where I want it to end is shortly after this. So we can play this back and find out where the end of my speech is. And that's where we're going to trim to. So you can see I say Figma, and that's kind of the end of it. So let's grab the handle here again and drag that all the way there. It's easy as that. Now, if you want a little bit more accuracy when it comes to trimming, you can click on the handle and you can see it gets this like light blue, light purple outline. And when you see that, that means it's selected, and you can now use your keyboard to adjust the trim point much more incrementally. So this can be handy if you're doing more precise movements and only need to adjust it by a few milliseconds at a time. So we've fixed up that clip, and the next thing for us to do is to work through the next clip and make the same changes. Now here on this next clip, you can see that we've got our screen and camera, and the same principle applies. We can just grab the handle at the start and adjust that to a point where I start speaking. So let's see where that happens.
Okay.
So
this is my
We can probably cut out the okay and the so, and so we can set the point that we want to trim based on that.
Okay, so.
So yeah, we don't need me saying okay, so, because I say that too much. And I've paused the playhead here. And so all I want to do is grab this and then let it snap into place at that point. And this is the perfect starting point. So you can just pick the point at which you want to trim to. So you just find that like this, and then that can be your guide. And so you can just grab the handle and then move it to exactly that spot so you can get the most accurate trim. So the next thing for us to do is to remove some mistakes in the middle of the video. So we've only been talking about trimming the start and the end, but that's not always it. Sometimes there's stuff in the middle, like ums and ahs and silences and weird things that you say that you want to cut out. And so I want to remove a part from the middle of my video. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So let's just see where my speech ends.
System.
So I can see I'm kind of rambling there. That's not what I want to include in the video.
And collaboration features are great.
So I want to stop it there at great. And then I'm going to hit X on my keyboard, or I can press the split key. So if I press split, you can see that that now makes two separate segments. So the next thing for us to do is to find out where we want to pick the speech up again and cut out everything in the middle. So yeah, just after that, that's where I want to cut out. So I hit X again or hit the split button. And now I've got these three segments. And so I want to keep this one and keep this one, and this middle one I want to get rid of, and I can just press delete, and now we're done. And so you can play that back and see how that sounds.
Collaboration features are great. Who's this for? Basically for us.
It just picks up exactly where I want it to, which is on this next part of the slide. And all this rambling in the middle, I can get rid of that stuff. Now, the last part of fixing mistakes that I want to show you and to talk about is cropping. So cropping is where you fix your screen recording. So here you can see I've recorded my screen. It is a demo of Figma, an application on my computer, and it's kind of got everything I want to be in there, but it's got this menu bar from my Mac at the top, which I don't really need in there. It doesn't really add a lot to it. I'm not ever interacting with it. It's just kind of a distraction from the main content. So you can head over here and press this button, crop screen. And then that will open up this crop tool on the canvas here, and you can just grab the handles and adjust that to the point at which you want to cut off. So we can say we want to cut it there. And equally, if you wanted to remove other parts, so maybe you wanted to cut off this, then you can do the same thing like that. This is really handy for removing unnecessary stuff from your screen recording, so you get a much cleaner end result. So if ever you record something in full screen and there's a part of it that you don't want there, you can just use this tool to tidy it up. So now that we have fixed up our recordings, it's time to make them look a little bit nicer by adding some style. So the first thing we're going to do is to work on our video's layouts. So we've got four different clips here, and there's two different kinds of them. These two are both screen recordings, and then the last and first are both camera only recordings. So we're going to have two different types of layouts that we're going to be using here. Now, for this first one, this is just me going through a series of slides. And so this kind of layout is actually pretty good because there isn't a ton of information on the screen. It's all quite readable. So it makes sense to keep some emphasis on me, the speaker, because I will expect that viewers will need to watch what I'm saying for a decent amount of it. So this layout is pretty good, but we could change that by clicking on the layout option. And then there's a bunch of other options that we can try. So something like this puts a bit more emphasis on the screen, but still keeps the camera quite present. And I think I will stick with this option for this clip. Now, if I wanted all of the other screen recording clips to match this, I could click this button here, Apply to All Clips. And what that does is it means that this clip now matches that. You can see that these two align quite nicely, besides my insane face. However, on this video here, on this clip here, we're doing a screen recording, and so I'm going into quite a bit of detail, and there's lots of parts of the screen that I want to show. And also, you can see that my camera kind of overlaps with a decent amount of what's happening on screen. So this layout probably isn't the best, and so instead of having the matching, I would pick a more appropriate layout like this one here, where it keeps my camera bubble out of the way, and then a lot more of the screen is visible, and it keeps kind of the screen as the main focus. And so layouts like these, any one where you see a bigger screen and a smaller camera, are generally the best option when you have a lot of information that you're trying to show on screen. For slides or screen recordings that don't involve much detail or go into a lot of detail on the screen, you can do something which puts more emphasis on the speaker. Now, for the camera only layouts, this layout is pretty good, but you can see there's a few layouts you can choose from. So if you want something a little bit more fun like this, then you've got those options. You can also full screen it as well. I think I'm going to stick with this one here, and the same principle applies, is you can press Apply to All Clips, and that will make the other matching clips align with that layout. So now we've got our layout sorted, let's go and work on the background. So the background is one of the funnest things to customize. It really adds a lot of personality to your video and it's very easy to use. So you can just click on the background option here and let me take you through what you can do. So you can pick from an image, an animation, or a color background. On the image backgrounds, you can upload your own, search through Unsplash, use some of Tella's defaults, or pick a Mac OS background. Unsplash has a lot of fun images that you can search from that might match the content of your video, but the best way to really add your branding to it is to upload your own background. So you can make a 16:9 background, add your own logo, text, or anything like that, and upload it into Tella, and then you can reuse that over and over to add some branding and style to your video that matches your brand. So here's one that has a lot of Tella branding, which looks quite fun. And you can see if I go into see all, I've got a full library of backgrounds that I've uploaded. Some of them have branding, some of them are just for fun. Here's an example with the Tella logo in the corner. There's some more that you can kind of get some ideas from. Now, if you switch over to the animated option, you can see these are all animated looping animations. And so you can hover over the thumbnail here to see how that looks. And then if you select that and play back the video, you'll see the effect.
This is my presentation in Figma.
It's pretty cool. And finally, you've got the color option. So here you can add your own brand color and then save that into your little color library here. You can also make your own custom gradient. There's a few cool ones that are added by default that you can already try out. But again, you can add your branding colors and adjust the settings here to make a gradient that matches your brand. I think for this presentation, for this video, I'm going to use this background here because this matches what I've got on screen in the slides. It sort of has the same color scheme. And then just like we did with the layouts, we can hit apply to all clips. And that's going to mean that every other clip has this nice green and teal gradient going on in the background. So that's how to add backgrounds. Now, last thing we're going to look at when it comes to adding style is borders. So head over here and open up the border tool. The first thing you can do is to choose which shape of a border you want. So this is the corners of the layers on screen. And so we've got default, we've got round as the default at the moment, but I can click on the sharp and you can see how that looks. Same principle applies. You can apply that to all clips and now you can see that this has some sharp corners. I think because I've got this kind of grid pattern in here, I'm going to stick with the sharp corners because that matches quite nicely. So once you've picked the shape of the border, then you can pick the style. Of course, you can have none. I've got drop shadow, which is the default style applied, which looks quite nice. But then you've got ones like this, which kind of add this sort of cartoon border, and you can choose which side that pops out. And then we've also got this transparent one. And I think I'm going to stick with the transparent one. That looks quite nice. And again, I'm going to apply that to all clips. And so my whole video is nicely aligned with its appearance. So that's how you apply borders. So now our video is looking really nice. The last thing for us to do in this editing lesson is to add some zooms so we can highlight some of the detail that we cover in our recordings. So to add zooms, head over to the top right and press zoom. You just need to make sure you're on a clip that has a screen recording. Zooms only apply to screen recordings. You can't add them to camera recordings. That'll take you into the zoom mode. And here you get another timeline, a little bit like we saw in the trim view. But this time we are adding zooms. And to add a zoom, you just press this button here or press the button here. And that will add a this little segment onto the timeline, which indicates the duration of the zoom that we're applying. We can adjust the duration just by grabbing the handles, or we can change its position by moving it along the timeline like this. So once you've got it applied, then you can start changing its other properties. So if you head up to the top right here, you can choose the focus point, which is where you want the zoom to focus in on, and its scale. So you can see how far you want it to be zoomed in. If you have a relatively low resolution recording, you probably don't want to zoom in so much that you start to see too much pixelation. So if you have a higher resolution, then you can zoom in quite far. But for this, I'll probably stick to like 150 maybe. And then you can also adjust the speed at which the camera zooms in, or I guess the screen zooms in. So let's start with medium and I'll show you how that looks. So you can see it adjusts like that. If I switch it to slow, we can watch that again. And you can see that zoom in there. Now the best way to use zooms is to focus in on something you want to show on the screen. Usually it will be where your mouse is going, so you can use zooms to track the mouse movement, or you can highlight a particular thing that you might be talking about at that point. The next thing I want to show you is how you can combine zooms together. So if I add this zoom here, and then let's set the focus point to be in the top left, and if I add another zoom here, and this time set the focus point to be in the top right, we can see the effect that having these two zooms connected has. So if I play this back,
so if we select a particular layer here,
you can see rather than it zooming out, it just tracks to the next zoom and moves to that new focus point. And you can add these in a series, and again kind of see the effect that that has. Now if the zooms aren't connected, they will just behave in the default way, which is to zoom in and then zoom out. So to connect them, you just make sure that they're touching each other like that, and then you can create that sort of series of movements. And again, you can adjust the handles to change the duration. You don't need to have them at the default level like this. So that is everything we need to cover when it comes to editing in Tella. We started with fixing mistakes using the trim and split tool. We also removed parts from our screen recording using the crop tool. Then we styled our video by adding a background, some borders, and some nice layouts. And then we finished by adding some zoom effects so we can highlight particular bits of detail on our screen. Remember, Tella is a simple but powerful tool. The idea is that it focuses on the use cases of us as entrepreneurs, so it makes it efficient for us to create the videos that matter to us, things like demos, tutorials, and online courses. I'll see you in the next lesson, where we look at storage, distribution, and sharing our videos.